Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the PixelPlusUI ROM for the Redmi Note 10 Pro. So as you can see here, it is based out of Android version 12 and it also has the latest Android security patch level as of now. So let's have a look at the launcher here. And this is basically the Pixel launcher. Let me go through the features that this one offers. So as you can see here, the usual stuff like add new app icons, swipe to access Google app on the left side, suggestions. Do note that this comes with inbuilt Google apps, so you do not need to flash them separately. It comes with apps like Chrome, Photos, the Google search app, and you can allow the home screen rotation here, like here, and you have some suggestion options. I like to turn them off for the home screen, and let's go back. Do note that I'm using Magisk and I'm using the Universal Safetynet fix basically to make my banking apps work. So I installed this Universal Safetynet fix and then I would go into the settings and I have enabled Zygisk beta, and I would also enforce the denial list and add the apps I do not want to detect root to this list, and it does work pretty well. And let's go in here. Here you have the quick settings. As you can see here, these are the usual options that you'd find. You can also turn off camera access or mic access with just one flick of the switch. And here are some other usual options like AOD. Talking about AOD, well, if you are using AOD, then you would lose about 5% to 6% of battery life every hour on this particular ROM. So in my opinion, that is pretty high. And I would suggest you that you do not use AOD with this particular ROM. Let's go in further. And talking about AOD, let's go to the display section. Here you'll find lock screen content. And do note that you can use face unlock in this particular ROM. That is hidden away in the security settings. And you have ambient display option. So I have turned on always on display, but you can disable that as well and use these other features. But I use always on. And you can enable media cover art music visualizer. Let's go back. And you have night light live display, as you can see here. You can also enable the anti-flicker mode if you really go down in terms of, say, usage of your screen, and it will help to reduce the strain in low light condition. And you can also turn on the reading mode to read some ebooks or stuff like that. You can also change the color calibration, picture adjustment, and you have display mode, and you have options. I use boosted because that makes everything look better in my opinion. You have this option for smooth display, and it will basically raise the refresh rate from 60 to 120 hertz for some content. And you have tap to sleep, double tap to wake, and you can also enforce full screen on certain apps. And let's go into the system settings, and here you'll find some stuff that is usually found like the developer options and the operator as well. And now let's go back and have a look at the custom settings that this particular ROM offers. But before that, let's go into the wallpaper and style settings. You can also access these using the launcher, but you can use themed icons, change the app grid basically, say to 5x5, and apply it. As you can see here, everything has changed in my launcher. Let's go back and let's jump right back into the settings. And as you can see here, you have the Pixelizer options here, and all the custom features have been hidden over here. And I'm using this Force black background colors, so that gives me a really good black theme. Let me disable that and you'll realize how that looks later on. And you have some custom color options, like you can use certain colors. And as you can see, it turned kind of grayish. And let's go back. You can also use linear brightness, but I don't know why. Okay, so now I've enabled this custom color and the screen will turn kind of red, but you can disable that as well. It takes a while to kick in, and if I use this black theme again, after a while it will go to full black. And here are some custom status bar options. As you can see here, you can enable the network traffic monitor, and this is how the volume panel looks. Let me turn into silent. And you have option for the activity, network activity, show arrows or not. And here you can also turn on live transcription, so basically it will give you automatic captions on any video content. And here you have some battery bar options. as you can see here. And you can also have some options for the battery percentage. You also have clock settings. You can auto hide the clock, show AM/PM, change the location, and certain date format. So as you can see here, there are a lot of status bar customization, as many as you would need. And you also have privacy indicators, location privacy indicator, mic and camera privacy indicator, and you have quick pull down on the right. You have small mobile icon type, and here in the quick settings you will have certain options, like you can show the quick settings footer text. As you can see here, it shows up here on the left above this edit icon. And you have battery estimate option. You can also enable this clear on notification button. And let's go in further. You have some button options here. The gesture settings are hidden away. You can enable gesture navigation, two button navigation, or three button navigation. And these are the options you would find. You have long swipe actions. You can change the sensitivity, pill length, and also the height where the back gesture is enabled. You can also enable full screen gestures and hide the navbar pill for a more immersive experience. And let's have a look at the features that are offered in the other two. Nothing special here, because I mostly use the gestures. And you can also customize power button options. As you can see here, you can hold for assistant, advanced restart, certain options you can enable for the restart menu. As you can see here, you can also access the restart menu from here. And let's go in. You have long press for torch. You can end the call, and you can wake the device using the volume button, answer call, or control playback. And you can also use the volume buttons as a keyboard cursor while you are typing. You can enable partial screenshots. You have gesture options like quick start by tapping on the back of the phone for certain features, and they do work pretty well and quite reliably. And we already had a look at these ones. You can enable the one-handed mode, as you can see here, and you can also enable this shortcut, but let's hide that. You have swipe to screenshot by using three fingers. You have playback control. So as you can see here, there are a lot of features here, despite this being a closed Pixel experience room. And you can customize lock screen, like you can force the small clock, show lock screen charging info, tap to sleep, hide quick settings on secure lock screen. And you also have certain notification options, like you can vibrate on call, change status like connecting a call, call waiting, or disconnect. And you can also blink the flashlight for incoming call to get your attention. And you have game space as well, as you can see here. You can disable heads up, change the ringer mode, block full screen event like some apps which take up the whole screen. You can disable that, disable auto brightness. So basically, if your hand moves over the proximity sensor, that changes the brightness. That shouldn't happen here. And you can disable USB ducking, but debugging, but that doesn't really matter. And you can launch music app on headset connection, invert three button navigation bar, ignore Windows secure flags, and you can also show the volume panel on the left. So overall, this is a pretty smooth room. I have been enjoying it. The performance is great here. Overall, I'm really liking this room. The battery life is pretty solid as well. You can get around 5.5 to 6 hours of SOT on heavy usage. So overall, it is pretty good. But if you are someone who does not like Google apps, stay away from this one. But if you someone who regularly uses Google apps like Chrome, the Google search bar, and handy features like the live transcript here that I showed you, and also want some customizations, this is the room to get. So that's it for this video. If you'd like to click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos.